साइंस टीचर मिस रूमा मैम विल टीच यू चैप्टर 5 कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम. सो कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम आर द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज विच वी गेट फ्रॉम द नेचर डायरेक्टली. ओके, सो दीज आर द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज, कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम. सो फर्स्टली यू विल लर्न अबाउट वॉट आर नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. सो नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज आर द रिसोर्सेज विच वी गेट डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द नेचर. सो नॉट ओनली नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज, फॉर मेनी थिंग्स वी आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन द नेचर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी आर डिपेंड ऑन द नेचर फॉर फूड. ओके, फॉर फूड, शेल्टर एंड फॉर मेनी अदर थिंग्स वी आर डिपेंड ऑन नेचर ओनली. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सनलाइट, तो सनलाइट इज ऑल्सो अ नेचुरल थिंग. सो इट इज ऑल्सो अ नेचुरल रिसोर्स. सो वी आर डिपेंडेंट फॉर लाइट ऑल्सो वी आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन नेचर. So what are the things that are making our life possible on earth? So these are water, sun, okay, and many other things are also there, like oxygen. As we get oxygen from air now, if air or water is not present on our environment, then how could we survive? Okay, so these are some important things that are very useful for us to survive. Okay, so now we will learn about there are two types of natural resources. Okay, as natural resources are categorized into two types of resources. First is renewable resource and the second is non-renewable resource. So firstly, we will learn about what are renewable resources. Renewable or non-exhaustive resources. Non-exhaustive means which cannot be exhausted so easily. As we can see, the sunlight, air, they cannot be finished, okay, by the human activities also. If we will take them in a very unlimited quantity also, then also they will not get finished, okay, because they are renewable, they can be renewed again and again. Okay, so example, air, water and sunlight, they are present in unlimited quantity in our environment, okay, and also called as non-exhaustive resources. It means that it cannot get exhausted so easily. Now second is non-renewable resource. Non-renewable resource means they will get exhausted, okay, they cannot be replenished or renewed again. So these are coal, petroleum, minerals, okay, plants and animals. So all these are what? Non-renewable. It means that they cannot be renewed. That's why we are said that we have to use these resources in a limited quantity so that a future generation can also get these resources like we are getting. Okay, so we have to use these resources in very limited amount, okay, in very conservative manner. So these are resources. We can say fossil fuels. What is fossil fuel? Fossil fuels are those substances which are present from millions of years ago, okay, from the dead remains of animals. Okay, these are formed by the dead remains of animals from millions of years ago. These fuels are called as fossil fuels. So coal and petroleum are the substituents of what? Fossil fuels. Okay, they are also a type of fossil fuels. So they cannot be renewed. Why? Because they need millions of years ago for the formation of fossil fuels. Okay, so we don't have enough time for a future generation because a future generation is near. Okay, we don't have the time of millions of years ago so that they can get it afterwards. Okay, so we have to use these resources in such a way that these resources which we are using, same resources are used by a future generation, okay, easily. So now we will learn about, firstly we will learn about coal. As the fossil fuels are coal and petroleum, so firstly we will know about what is coal. So coal, I think all of you have seen, the coal is a black colored substance, okay, all of you have seen now. Coal is black colored substance and it is a solid. Okay, so what are the main constituents of coal? These are carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur. These are the important constituents of coal. And where coal is found? Coal is found under the coal mines, under the earth crust it is found. Mainly it is found in Bihar, Odisha, West Bengal and Madhya Pradesh. So I think coal is clear to all. Now we will learn about how the coal is being formed. See, the coal is being formed after millions of years ago as the more and more pressure is being applied on that part. Okay, for example, firstly it was a forest, then the forest was decomposed, then again the soil is being formed over that forest, and many animals, plants used to die. So because of their pressure, the pressure on the earth increased. By that pressure, by that high pressure, the coal is being formed. And this process of formation of coal is called as carbonization, because coal is a carbon compound. So the process of formation of coal is called as carbonization. Now we learn about how coal is reduced to any other resources. Like coal, for making byproducts of coal, destructive distillation takes place. So what is destructive distillation? Destructive distillation means heating of coal at very high temperature. Okay, when the coal is heated at very high temperature without the supply of oxygen, then this process is called as destructive distillation of coal. And after destructive distillation, what are the byproducts which are formed? First is coal gas, coal tar, and the last is coke. Okay, these three substituents are formed after the destructive distillation of coal. So what is coal gas? What is coal gas? During the formation of coal tar and coke from the coal, the gas is released. That gas is called as coal gas. Okay. And in that gas, which gases are present? Methane, hydrogen and carbon monoxide. These three gases are present when the coal gas is released during the formation of coal tar and coke. So coal gas is a type of gas. Okay. Now coal tar. What is coal tar? Coal tar is a liquid. Okay, coal gas is a gas, coal tar is a liquid. It is of black color. Obviously, coal is of black color, so coal tar will also be of black color. And how it is used? It is used for the covering of roads in earlier times, but now bitumen is used. What is bitumen? That you will learn afterwards. Now coke. What is coke? Coke is a solid substance which is formed after destructive distillation of coal. Okay. It is used for making of different type of metals. Okay. It is used for making steel also. It is also a good fuel because it used to give more and more heat than coal, because it contains 98% of carbon content. It has 98% of carbon content in it. That's why it is a good fuel. Now, all of you, I have told you about coal. Now, uses of coal. What are the important uses of coal? As you all know, coal is used in domestic purposes. Okay, as a domestic fuel for making food in villages. Okay, it is used for making food in villages, for cooking food. Next is, it is also used in ancient times. It is used for running the steam engines. Okay, and next is, it is used to obtain coke and coal gas. Okay, now we will learn about petroleum. So what is petroleum? Petroleum is also a fossil fuel. Okay, and where it is found? It is found in Gujarat, Assam, Bombay, and in the river basins of Krishna and Godavari. Okay, petroleum is found in these regions. Now, formation of petroleum. As the formation of coal is being done, same the formation of petroleum is also being done. Why? Because it is also a type of fossil fuel. Next, extraction of petroleum. It means that how petroleum is being extracted from the earth crust. So as you all know that petroleum is found inside the earth crust. And one more thing, petroleum is found with the natural gas. Okay, just above the water surface, petroleum and natural gas are found. Okay, they will not mix with water because they are lighter than water. And they are extracted with the help of big drilling machines. Okay, by drilling machines, the holes are being made, and these holes are called as oil wells. And from these oil wells, we will get natural gas and petroleum coal. Now, in petroleum, the topic is refining of petroleum. Because the refining is being done, because petroleum which we have extracted from the earth surface is not pure. So we have to refine that petroleum. So, refining of petroleum is done by the process called as fractional distillation. Now see. So, this is fractional distillation. Okay. By this. So, fractional distillation, it cannot be done simply. Okay. Refining of petroleum cannot be done simply by sieving or something. So, one big process is used for the refining of petroleum, and that process is called as fractional distillation. And by the process of fractional distillation, different components which are present inside the petroleum will get separated. Okay? Now, what are these components? The byproducts which are formed after fractional distillation of petroleum, these are petroleum gas, petrol, kerosene, diesel, lubrication oil, paraffin wax and bitumen. So, what is petroleum gas? Petroleum gas is used in a domestic purposes. In LPG also it is used. So what is the full form of LPG? Liquefied petroleum gas. So we can say that petroleum is also a good fuel for cooking purposes. Next is petrol. What is petrol and why it, how it is used? So petrol is used as a fuel in automobiles, all you know. Okay, it is also used for dry cleaning purposes. Okay, next is kerosene. So where kerosene is used? Kerosene is used as a cheaper fuel. Okay, in jet airplanes also it is used. Okay, jet aircraft it is used, kerosene. Next is diesel. Diesel is also used in automobiles. Okay, in generators also it is used. Lubrication oil. Lubrication oil is used to resist the rusting of iron. Okay, that's why lubrication is used, so that machine will run smoothly. Okay, that's why lubrication is done. Next is paraffin wax. What is paraffin wax? Wax. It is also a type of wax which is used to make candles. It is also present in creams and vaseline. Okay. Next is bitumen. So bitumen is used for waterproofing purposes. Okay. And for making the top surfaces of the roads. Okay. Understood everyone? What is coal and what is petroleum? How they are formed? And what are the processes of refining of these? Okay, now next most important topic is natural gas. So what is natural gas? Natural gas is a gas which is used as an excellent fuel because it does not create pollution. Okay, it is a very good fuel. As we can say CNG. So why CNG is used in automobiles? We can use petrol also, we can use diesel also. So why CNG? Because CNG creates less pollution. Okay, that is why we have to use CNG in our vehicles. Okay. And the main constituent of natural gas is methane. This one you should learn. What is the main constituent of natural gas? It is methane. Okay. Now some points to remember are, natural gas is a good fuel. Why it is a good fuel? Because it does not leave any residue. Residue means any remain. Okay. It does not leave any remains of that after burning. Next is, it gives lot of heat on combustion. Okay, after combustion it gives lot of heat, that's why it does not leave any residue after that. Okay, next is, it does not produce any smoke, that's why it is a non-polluted gas, natural gas. One more thing you have to remember is that petroleum and natural gas are used for making chemicals, and these chemicals are called as petrochemicals. Okay? Petroleum and natural gas are used to make some substances. These chemicals are called as petrochemicals. So I have told you the advantages of natural gas. What are the advantages of natural gas? Why it is good? Okay? So you all have learned why natural gas is a good fuel. Now we will learn about disadvantages of fossil fuels. Why fossil fuel is also a disadvantage? See, because due to burning of fossil fuels, the main gas which used to release is carbon dioxide. But carbon dioxide, as you all know, it is also a main gas for the cause of global warming. Okay, that is why the production of carbon dioxide increases the temperature of our environment, and it will cause global warming. Or we can say greenhouse effect. So it is also a very big disadvantage of fossil fuel. Next is, what is next? It causes acid rain. What is acid rain? एसिड रेन इज कॉज्ड बाय द एसिड्स व्हिच यूज्ड टू गेट मिक्स्ड विद द एयर प्रेजेंट इन आवर एनवायरनमेंट. ओके, सी व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेन द इंडस्ट्रीज वेयर सम हार्मफुल गैसेस यूज्ड टू रिलीज, वी कैन से नाइट्रोजन, सल्फर, ओके, दीज टाइप ऑफ गैसेस, सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड एंड मेनी अदर, दे यूज्ड टू गेट मिक्स्ड विद द एयर एंड एयर कंटेन मॉइस्चर आफ्टर सम टाइम व्हेन इट रेन्स. So this type of rain also used to fall down and it will fall on our skin, on the soil. So it will cause a lot of damage to these things. As it can also cause many skin diseases. It can cause blisters on our skin. And it makes the soil infertile, which is not good for growing crops. Okay. So these are some disadvantages of fossil fuel. Next is, if we will burn coal in a closed room, then it will release some very poisonous gas, and that poisonous gas is called as carbon monoxide. Okay, by the releasing of carbon monoxide, we will get suffocation, and if we will stay there for a very long time, then we will die also. Okay, so it is a very harmful for us. Okay, to stay in that situation. Okay, it is very harmful. So never allow burning of coal in a closed room, okay, because it is very dangerous for us. It can cause death also. Now these are some disadvantages of fossil fuels. Now we will learn about, as the chapter come to an end, so we will learn about how we will conserve these resources. So conserve means to save. How we will save these natural resources for our future generation. So first is, do not waste it. As you want these resources in that amount only, you have to use in limited amount only, so that it will not get waste. Never use these bikes and cars, use them but at a very limited amount. Okay, don't use in very extraordinary. Okay, because it will cause a lot of pollution in the environment, and it is also not good for a natural resources, because our natural resources will get wasted. Okay, whenever you are traveling from any from your car or from your bike, so whenever a red signal comes, always use to stop that engine, because if you will not stop, then your petrol will get wasted, and if your petrol will get wasted, then our natural resources will get wasted. So this is not a good thing. Okay, next is, always use air conditioners whenever necessary. Okay, don't use it unnecessarily. For example, if you are not sitting in a car, okay, then also you are using air conditioners, and then it is not good. Okay, so these are some ways by which we can conserve our natural resources. Try to use cycles in place of bikes. Okay, try to use cycles, or you can use your foot also. God has gifted you with very good thing, your legs. So try to move with your legs. Okay, try to use your legs. Drive a bicycle instead of these bikes and cars. It will be good. It will not create any pollution also, and it is used for the conservation of our natural resources. So this is all about this chapter. I think you all have understood this chapter very well. Thank you.